So I'm going to take this cast iron skillet. I'm going to sand it down a little bit smoother, spray paint it, and then I'm going to try and etch in something on the pan. That way, when you're using it to cook something, I'm hoping that it'll have a nice burn into whatever I'm cooking, the logo that I put on here. It's Father's Day. I think I'm going to put Happy Father's Day. A couple grill symbols, and let's see how this works. Dry them and do a second coat. Alright, so here's my setup. I got the pan painted, laser set to the right depth inside the pan. And then go ahead. With a it'll cut everything that's black, and everything that's pink it will not cut. So I'm going to do a have all the letters raised and the images raised, that way it'll kind of sear into the food. Let's go ahead and test the circle. So if I change this over the line, get the laser set for 1%. Just want to make sure it's not going to collide with the pan. And that looks like it's good. So if I select everything I want to burn the paint off, let me change this over to fill. So that's what we're going to etch in the pan. I'm gonna go ahead and change the output. Make that 100. And start it. So let's slow this down and start it. Alright, it's just about done. In order to etch this, I'm going to have all the paint burnt off. It doesn't look like it burnt through everything. You've got to have bare metal and everything that's got to be etched. So I will probably run this again, maybe 2 times. Alright, so this isn't coming out like I hoped. Go ahead and move, raise this up, pull this out. So it's still black. I was kind of hoping the laser would burn through the dark of the cast iron, and it didn't. So I'm thinking if I etch this, I'm going to get it very uneven. So either I try and etch it as is, or I sand it down further to bare metal and just do it again. I'm not sure what I'm going to do here. Now we're gonna etch it. Alright, so the etching is gonna be an electro etch. I'm gonna pour some salt water in here, put a grid over it, connect the positive to the handle of the pan, negative to the metal grid I have here. A couple of spaces to keep that up off the bottom. Put salt water. So I took out some of the water. This will etch only the stuff where the paint's been removed. I don't think I have a good connection on that ground. Oh yeah, I do. So here's the first 5 minutes. Get all the carbon off, but I don't want to take the paint off. Etch it again. Let's run it for at least another 5 minutes. Go one more time. All right, I think that should be enough time. Shut this off. Nail started rusting. Thank you. like how deep it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and wash it off upstairs in the sink with some soap and water. Yes, cast iron, soap and water. Don't yell at me. Then we're gonna clean off all the paint with paint thinner, acetone. Wash it again, then we'll season it and hopefully give it a try today. All right, here comes the fun part, cleaning off all the paint. The good thing about this paint is it's acetone based, so it actually comes off real easy with acetone. Frying pan, like in the cast iron frying pan with all the little crevices. Yeah, not that easy. We'll get it all off. I'm gonna wash it real good. I'm gonna try and season it. Hopefully, washing it will get rid of the acetone smell. All right, so I washed it off. Put some baking soda on it just to try and get rid of the odor. Really just washing it, I think, got rid of the acetone odor. Then I oiled it up. Vegetable oil, I'm gonna season it. After round one of seasoning, I'm going to season it one or two more times. See a very small circle there. Maybe if the etch was deeper. I'll have to try it with steak and see if it sears into the steak. It's very subtle. But you can see it very lightly. Gonna have to try it on a steak and see how it comes up. All right, so in the end, it didn't work to brand whatever you etch in the pan into the food. I was afraid, I think maybe going deeper might work, but I do have this deep stamp on the back of the pan that I was afraid was going to wear through and make thin spots in the pan. So I didn't want to go too deep. I think if you went deeper with this, I think that would brand better into the meat or pancakes or whatever you're making. Either way, even if you just don't do a reverse etch and put your name on it or put a logo on it, I think it's still going to look cool. Give it a try. Let me know what you think.